Hey guys, what's going on? Michael Antonovich with SWAT Moto Live, bringing you this new feature presented by our friends at Racetech. Unfortunately, I don't have a name for it right now because it's very much a work in progress, so you're going to sit through this first one. They'll get better, I promise. It's just very different for me to sit on this side of the camera and just kind of go at random for a bit. Luckily, I have my wife here to help kind of keep the train on the tracks because we tried to do one of these the other night before I flew to California for round three in San Diego. It's a mess. I'm talking too fast. I don't catch my breath. Rambled quite a bit. So we're going to try this again. Shout out to Chris at Racetech for making this feature possible and also for giving me a minute to figure it out because I'm coming off of spending 14 days of the month in Southern California. You know, it's January 21st right now. I've been home for 2 hours since flying back from San Diego for yesterday's race. So I've been in SoCal for a bit. It's awesome. You know, I lived there for 8 years. So to do the whole first month of the year out there, be wrapped up in the racing scene is awesome because every day there's something going on. I think that's what makes that first month of the year so fun, but it's also pretty hectic. So it's how you get to January 21st and you haven't done one of your first big projects for the year. Again, shout out to Chris for having this come together because admittedly, I wouldn't make content like this. I don't think on my own. It's just odd to be on the other side of the camera, but thanks to Chris for making me get out of my comfort zone. Like I said, these will get a lot better. So as always, I know you guys are going to sound off in the comments about what I need to do. Let me know because I'm going to try to do everything a step up every week. So let's get into it. Dude, 14 days goes fast. Like I said, it's been split up over two different trips. I went out right before Anaheim 1 on January 4th, stayed through that next week, rode bicycles and motorcycles with Don, flew up to San Francisco, stood in the mud for that one, flew back, spent a couple days at home in the deep freeze of Illinois while we were in, you know, sub-zero temperatures and our pipes froze and everything. So very big juxtaposition from SoCal. And then on Thursday morning, flew back, hit the Toyota of Escondido party on Thursday night, and then was at the races all day Friday and all day Saturday and back home. So it's unbelievable that we're already 3 weeks into it. They do go so fast. And as I was talking to some friends this weekend, there's something going on every day now, you know, between events that are happening, news that's happening, work that's got to be done, places to go, people to see. It does go pretty quick. Like I said, it's unbelievable. We're 21 days into the new year already, three races in. And we're already kind of coming to the end of the California swing. In a couple days, we're going to jump back on the plane, go to SoCal, and wrap it up with like a 5 or 6 day stay in Orange County to knock out the last one. But they go fast. And I know this next week that comes up is probably going to be the busiest one of them all, even compared to Anaheim 1. Anaheim 1, you're just kind of trying to go through the routine. Everybody knows that they have last minute stuff to do, parties to go to, credentials to get, press conferences, press day, the racing, all of that stuff. As everybody's about to leave now, the big East Coast migration will hit. All of the guys that moved to SoCal for the winter will start bailing soon. It's next week, everybody's going to be wrapping up as much as they can before it's time to head out. The first month is gnarly, though. You really want to know how much. It's the same for everybody. I know all the racers and teams, everybody talks about, like, I can't wait to do this in the off season. I worked on this. I have this new agenda in my program. We've worked on this with the bike. It's the same thing for everybody else. All of the media people have new content ideas. I'm sure you guys see that on social media right now, on YouTube, on websites. There's so many new content creators that are out there, and it's awesome. And I think that that's a big thing right now that's going on because traditional media is shifting, so it's projects like this are going to happen. You know, if you saw the news for Sports Illustrated over the week, big business media is changing quite a bit. And it's cool to see so many people taking advantage of what's possible to do now. Like even putting the studio set up together, which is admittedly upstairs in my house in Illinois with the camera I shoot, the races with every weekend, a ring light, and another light. It's unbelievable to see what is out there. And yeah, it's nuts to see how much everybody has built and built. So I know there's a ton of content people are watching on Sundays and Mondays through the races. For everybody else, though, like, it's chaos. There's people that are getting their wraps done on their semis that first week at Anaheim 1. Some teams are waiting for their, you know, official team apparel to show up with all the right sponsor logos. Graphics are getting dropped off. Parts are showing up. The first month is nuts, and it's not until you get to the end of it that you're like, wow, we made it through. People I was talking to this weekend were already kind of looking forward to the Detroit, the Arizona, the Texas races, because then you're in the routine. You're not in California getting pulled somewhere every day. You fly in once it's time to go to the airport Thursday or Friday, knock out all the work at the track, go back home. Whereas when you're in California, you're working all the time. I know that was especially true for all of the mechanics this past week between San Francisco and San Diego because it was a full thrash to get all your bikes cleaned up with how gnarly that first race was. Shout out to everyone to make that one happen. I mean, nobody wants to do a mud race for the second one of the year and then follow it up with a mud race at the third one of the year. But it being in SoCal, having so many of the race shops there, so many of the brands there, people that needed to get stuff done got what they needed to get done. I hit on this the other day and then we scrapped it because it's just so hectic for me to put out there. But those three races could not be any more different. You know, obviously, 7-8 hour drive from Anaheim to San Francisco, the Bay Area is a complete different thing than SoCal is. But then if you go an hour and a half between Anaheim to San Diego, whole different world down there. If you watch the news break video that I did from this weekend with Brock Glover, Brock hits on all of that perfectly because although Anaheim is like really the home to Supercross, and so many people see that, you know, Angel Stadium has hosted the most races, San Diego is really the home to the sport. The El Cajon zones there are so many of the brands and people that have become championship winners or iconic, you know, fixtures in the sport over these last 50 years have come from there. Anaheim is the race that everybody wants to go to, especially Anaheim 1. That's the one everybody looks forward to. You got to give it up to the NorCal crowd because even in the rain, everybody showed up in their rain jackets and waterproof boots and trash bags and ponchos they bought on the street. And they set through probably the muddiest race that we've had in a while. As you heard all the riders say, that was a completely different kind of slop than what we saw in New Jersey last year. And it was a complete different kind of mess than what we saw this weekend in San Diego. San Diego's cool because it's really had three different iterations in the years that I've gone to it. First time I went to the San Diego Supercross was in 2012, my first year working with Transworld full-time. And that was when it was at Jack Murphy Stadium. So, you know, out at Qualcomm, it was this just big, massive, cavernous-looking building on this concrete parking lot. And that was the party race. I knew that's where everybody wanted to go tailgate. Even for all the people that go to Anaheim 1, you go to San Diego to blow off some steam and have some fun. When it moved downtown to Petco, same thing. The party just moved over to the Gaslamp District. And now that we're at Snapdragon Stadium for the second year, and it's awesome because it's a brand new venue. It's pretty intimate. It's not as big as other ones are. It doesn't seem like there's a bad seat in the house. It's picking up on that whole, let's go down there, let's check it out, let's go to San Diego. But it doesn't have the history that Qualcomm Stadium had yet. I think a couple more years it'll get there. Couple more dry races, it'll get there. And again, shout out to the SoCal fans that sat through it because it was quite a boring day yesterday after they scrapped that practice and you just had to wait until the night show to see bikes on the track again. So yeah, I mean, as you would imagine, there's a ton of people you see at the first race of the year at Anaheim 1. I saw so many friends that I hadn't seen over the winter, and that's always great. But then you see industry people that are showing up, maybe have new jobs or new projects that they're working on. I would say the most surprising person that I met at Anaheim 1 was Pablo Chabatti. For people that don't know, he's going to be the leader of the Ducati off-road program. He's helped Ducati become just the force that they are in MotoGP over the last few years with bike development, aerodynamics, having so many bikes on the grid. And he's been reassigned within the company to help launch this off-road project that we're going to see a lot of this week as the bike gets debuted in Italy with Antonio Cairoli. So be sure to keep an eye out on that because I think we're going to see something completely different than what we were expecting in a lot of ways. As for everything else, yeah, I just see all my friends. Like I said, I've had this job for about 16 years, 13 years with a hard card, last 6 years with Swap Moto Live. So to go be around so many people that I've spent my entire adult life with, you know, seen them have kids, been to their weddings, been to after parties with them, they've seen my kid. It's fun to catch up with everybody and just see the excitement for right now because as we've talked about on the racing and in the content, like it's so good to see the action that's going on, but it seems like everybody else's enthusiasm to be at the track right now is sky high. And so like I said, we're going to keep this quick because we're learning a lot about it. So let's just get into what's ahead this week. Going back to Anaheim, first Triple Crown of the year. It's going to be completely different than what we saw at Anaheim 1 because temperatures will be high 70s, low 80s, the dirt's been setting there, and the vibe is different because we've seen three very chaotic rounds play out. Big swings in the point standings, championship changes, tensions ratcheting up between different guys out there on the track. So we're about to see the real interest take off. You add in a factor like Jorge Prado staying another race, three gate drops, shorter motos, really tight format that you have to make it through qualifying. Starting on Saturday, you'll see the intensity of everybody ratchet up a tick. Then we go to Detroit, completely different than everything we see in SoCal, and then it's back to Arizona, and then a week off. So first 5 weeks of the year have already flown by. It's unbelievable to think that we're already almost through the California swing. And for me, it's kind of bittersweet because, like I said, I spent 8 years of my life out there. So to go out and be in it, see everybody is great. But then at the same time, you know that there's so much other stuff that has to happen that has to get knocked out, that once you get in the routine, the job does become a little bit easier. People ask all the time if there's some races that you should go to, which ones. Obviously, Anaheim one's the dream. I know so many people that have made the trip from the East Coast or Australia or Europe, even this year, just to come see it. And that's unbelievable how dedicated the fans are for it. If you want to go see the big city, San Francisco's cool too. You know, don't let everybody, you know, scare you off by what they say. Just keep your head on a swivel. It's just like any big town. And if you want to go have fun, San Diego's a good one because all of Moto shows out for that. So three big recommendations there. And honestly, Anaheim 2 is probably the most slept on fun race of the year because the pressure of Anaheim 1 is not so much there. You get that first triple crown of the year and it's the last send off before everybody leaves California. Everybody wants to see each other and they know we're really about to get to work in the next few weeks. So if you ever can make the swing out to California in the month of January, be sure to do it. Thanks for watching this first episode of our Racetech sponsored project. We're going to work the bugs out on these as these next few weeks go on. So like I said in the start, you're going to drop recommendations on what you want to hear in the next few episodes. It's going to be like twice a month, maybe a little bit sooner if I can really get into a good routine. I think that if I do more of these, it's not going to feel so awkward, so forced, so how am I even catching my breath on all of this stuff? And I know if you guys want to hear about something, drop a comment below and I'll talk to you about it. I got some ideas, good food that I see on the tour, what it's like to just go through the routine every single weekend, drive to the airport at 5 o'clock in the morning on a Friday, be back at the airport 4 o'clock in the morning on Sunday when you have 2 hours of sleep, and just like what the routine's like, how you take everything in it. But it's whatever you guys want to talk about too, so be sure to hit me up. Thanks for watching this. And again, thanks to Chris at Racetech for making this possible. Really, really appreciate you making me get on the camera, Chris. Thanks for watching the first one. See you guys soon.